Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is your man, Daniel T. Adams of PerhapsToday.net, and today we have got an awesome Bible speed art video just for you. That's right. Let's roll it. Today is going to be a super special video because we've got an awesome kid who's going to be in it today. His name is, I'm not telling you his name yet. You have to wait and find out, but I will give you some clues. Clue number one, he's awesome.
He's awesome.
Clue two, he's got a huge heart of love. Clue three, he's been in videos before. You have seen him. Clue four, he's about this tall and he's holding my microphone for me right now so I can talk. Would you like to meet him? Enough of the intro, let's just go meet him. Whoa, everybody, here he is. His name is Gabriel, but I call him, Gabe, what's my nickname for you?
Zilla
Vanilla. I even have a cool theme song. Zilla Vanilla, he's so fast, just watch him go. And there's more to it, and there's like choruses, and it goes into a bridge, which is very dramatic, and there's tears flowing. It's really short, it's only two lines or whatever. But he has brought a friend with him today. Who's your friend there, Gabe?
Sticky.
What's up, Sticky?
I am a Stick.
I think we should draw a face on him. What do you think
Gabe should draw a face on Sticky, maybe give him some stick arms. This would be a true stick figure. Boom. That was a fake laugh. I was laughing for real.
I just went like, ha ha ha.
We were both fake laughing, but I put more heart into it. Speaking of heart, that is what this kid brings to everything he does. He has a huge heart. He's a giver. He loves people. He loves to serve people. Actually, Gabe, tell us for a second, what's one thing you wouldn't mind doing as a career somewhere?
I would like to be a director.
I'm very excited for this movie.
But also, I would like to be a teacher.
A teacher. See what I'm talking about? He's got a heart that wants to share and give to people. And so that is why Mr. Zilla Vanilla, AKA Gabriel Adams, is gonna be a part of this picture today. I'm excited, are you excited? Do you know anything about this picture that we're doing?
No.
He has no clue what this picture is gonna be, but I hope he's gonna enjoy it, and I hope he's gonna enjoy being part of it. Gabe, before we sign off, do you have any parting words you'd like to leave with our audience today?
Yes, be kind to others always.
So beautiful. Y'all heard it from him. Be kind to one another, be good. But how do we know how to be good or what that even means? Well, we have God's word, right, Gabe? And that's how we know what truth is. And that's how we know what goodness and kindness and all that good stuff is. So let's take a quick look at how we took these pictures. And then we're gonna get into the Bible speed art video. Gabe, would you like to hit the camera and sign us off?
Yes, sir. Goodbye.
Sticky! You're gonna be kinda like this, looking back. What's up, Zilla?
You take a brokenness and make like us beautiful. Yeah, that's how I know. I can't take that from me. Love came crashing in. Never gonna be the same again. Yeah, you came crashing in. You ripped me. You ripped me. Love came crashing in. Never gonna be the same again. Yeah, you came.
We're here to take pictures of the Bible. That's right, because every picture we do here at Perhaps Today is centered around one thing, and that's God's Word.
That's how I know.
And that is how we took these pictures. It's Bible speed art time. Let's get to it!
All right, thank you so much for sticking around to the Bible speed art portion of this video. As always, my name is Daniel T. Adams, and it is my pleasure to take you on this expedition. So with no further ado, I want to quickly preface that the young man who was a part of this video that you see on your screen, his name is Gabe, and I had him be a part of this video because A, he's awesome, but B, because it is his birthday. Gabe is turning 10 on the 4th of July this year, and I'm super, super proud of him and excited to have him be a part of this. So with that being said, let's take a look at the expedition we're on today. It's taking us into the Old Testament, to the book of Haggai, which is a really small book in the back of the Old Testament. It's only 2 chapters long. And we're going to take a look starting at verse 3, and we're going to see what was important back then and how it's also still very important to us to this day. So let's read first. Verse 3 says, "Then the word of the Lord came through the prophet Haggai. Is it a time for you yourselves to be living in your paneled houses while this house remains a ruin? Now this is what the Lord Almighty says. Give careful thought to your ways. You have planted much, but have harvested little. You eat, but never have enough. You drink, but never have your fill. You put on clothes, but are not warm. You earn wages, only to put them in a purse with holes in it. This is what the Lord Almighty says. Give careful thought to your ways. Go up into the mountains and bring down timber and build the house so that I may take pleasure in it and be honored, says the Lord." So I'm going to give some quick history what this section is talking about. Earlier in the Old Testament, in the book of Daniel, we read how the land of Judah was besieged by King Nebuchadnezzar and his kingdom of Babylon, and ultimately the temple of the Lord was destroyed. And that was the temple where they would offer their sacrifices, the presence of the Lord would dwell in their midst, and they'd find a covering of their sin for that year so that if they happened to die, their sins would be covered. But now here we are fast forwarding to the book of Haggai, and we see from other places in the Old Testament that the people, the exiles, when they came back into the land here, because that's what's going on, they're coming back into the land, they're starting to reestablish their life here in this land that the Lord had for them. They had already set up the foundation of the temple, but then they never finished building it. It just sat. And instead, they're building their own life. They're building their own homes. Their priority is themselves. And that's what the Lord is asking in verse 3. You know, you're living in your houses, you're building what you want to build, but the one house that my presence will dwell within to be in your midst, the one place where you can find a covering of your sin for that year. So the question is, what are you and I building in our lives? Is it the kingdom of the Lord so that he can be glorified, so that people can see Christ Jesus through our life? Or are we building whatever we want to build? Now, maybe the foundation's been laid and we say, oh, we've laid the foundation, and then move on to ourselves and justify that we can move on to what we want to move on to because we at least started the project. Starting the project is not the same as completing the project. Completing the project isn't the same as completing the project that is within the will of God and his purpose for your life. See, we can complete a lot of projects, a lot of us do. But if it isn't God's purpose for our life, then is it pleasing to the Lord? And that's the ultimate question he asks at the end of verse 8. He goes, build the house so that I may take pleasure in it and be honored. What are we building today? When you woke up this morning, what were your plans? Was it to build your kingdom or was it to build his? Was it to build a life for you that would ultimately point to the Lord Jesus Christ and what his offering and his sacrifice was so that you and I could enter the presence of the Lord? Did you catch that tie-in? Isn't that what the temple that was in ruins did for the Jews? It allowed them to have the presence of the Lord in their midst. Isn't that what Jesus has done through his sacrifice? Has allowed us to be in the presence of the Lord once again? He paid the price for all sin one time, once and for all. Even Paul writes this in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16. He says, "Don't you know that you yourselves are God's temple?" Oh, there's the tie-in. "And that God's Spirit lives in you?" There's his Spirit dwelling within you. Wow, what a question. If you were truly call on the name of the Lord, then you are that temple. But are you using that temple to bring glory and honor to the Lord? Are you seeking to please him or are you seeking to please yourself? See, a lot of us in the Christian world, we claim the name of Jesus and we think, oh, you know what? I go to church, I pay my tithe, I sing in the choir, maybe I teach a class, maybe I host a Bible study, maybe I help with the kids, maybe I coach a basketball team. We think we do all of these things, and that's somehow going to, you know, well, I did something, therefore now the Lord is pleased. Is that something God's purpose for your life? For you as His temple, where His Spirit is dwelling? See, a lot of people claim the name of Christianity. I mean, we just passed Pride Month. And what does that mean? There's a lot of people out there claiming Jesus and also saying, we're here, we're queer, and we're coming after your children. What kingdom are they building? Sounds like their own. Now, I'm not here to judge anything. I'm just here to look at the life we're living and ask the question, why am I doing what I'm doing? And is it part of the purpose and the will of God for my life? Or is it my agenda that I want to push, and that's the only thing I'm going to push, and that's all that matters, because I need to be equal with everyone else, and I need to, you know, have all this stuff. Really? What is God's purpose for your life? You see, that's why we did the picture we did. As you notice, this world that's being created here in Photoshop is a world of complete destruction. It's desolate. There's nothing growing. The highway there has had the middle fall out. And you'll see towards the end of the picture, there's someone at the other end hanging on for dear life, needing help. And we have this young man who could be building his agenda, who could be building whatever he wants to build. But instead, he's looking up to the heavens, and he's looking to the light of Christ shining through, and he's looking to how the Lord has provided him with these heavenly Lego blocks. And by the way, quick shout out to Lego. Gabe, I know you're a big fan of Lego, as am I, so I had to get Lego in the picture for you. So he's using these heavenly Lego to build not what he wants to build. Now, he could go out and build his home back again, because I'm sure, based on looking at this picture, his home's probably destroyed. He could be building his home. He could be building a school. He could be building, you know, some agenda. He could be rebuilding his bicycle. He could be rebuilding a park to go play at. He could be rebuilding things for his friends to come hang out with. No, what he's doing is he's looking to the heavens and he's saying, Lord, what do I do with this next block? And the Lord instructs, the Lord gives the direction, and he places the block. And what is it doing? It's building a bridge across this broken highway, and it's revealing the word of God. Because as he's obedient to the Lord, it reveals that the word of God is driving the whole thing. And we know that the word of God is spirit-breathed. And what that will reveal to the man hanging on for dear life on the other side is not that this kid is some special kid, but that the Spirit of God is alive and ready to offer him the help he needs. And the help isn't from just despair of falling from a bridge. The help is knowing who Christ is. The help is building the bridge between him and a heavenly, holy God who longs to see us all come into repentance so that we can all come into his presence. The purpose of the Father, as we learn from the book of 2 Peter, is for all of us to come to repentance. That's why he's patient. But how many of us are too busy building our own lives and our own agendas and our own kingdoms? Now, why did we call this the why of your life? Because that's what this picture is being called. Simply because twice in the section of Haggai, we see that the Lord says, give careful thought to your ways. Twice he says that. Meaning, it's time to establish and put your heart to what your actions and deeds are. That means discern your life. Discern not what your action is. Discern why you do what you do. See, the question that's important is not what I'm doing, where I'm doing it, when I'm doing it, who I'm doing it with. The question is, why am I doing what I'm doing? Because the question why reveals our motive, reveals that it is self-centered or it's Christ-centered. And he says that twice. The first time he tells them to discern and look at the why of what they're doing, he points out that you're spinning your wheels trying to plant, trying to have clothes, trying to drink, trying to have food, and it's not getting you anywhere. And you expect just because what you're a Jew living in the land I promised you that I'm going to just bless you when you could care less about building the one place where my presence can be in your midst? Well, that's no different than us today. Are we building a life that reveals that Christ is in our midst? When people look at you, do they see someone set apart from the world, set apart from the woke agenda, set apart from the political agendas, set apart from religious agendas, set apart from denominational agendas? And are you living a life to where people can see that Christ is in your midst? As Paul writes in the book of Romans chapter 12, 1 and 2, he says, therefore I urge you, brothers, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God. This is your spiritual act of worship. Are you a true worshiper? because the Father only cares about those who worship in spirit and in truth. Jesus tells us that in the Gospels. Are you worshiping because it's a checklist? Is your worship going to church, paying a tithe? Well, maybe those things are nice if that's where the Lord is leading you. If that is His purpose and direction for your life, then so be it. But are you even seeking to build yourself up into one who is set apart and revealing the presence of God in your life so that other people can see it and reach out for it and know that there's hope in Christ Jesus and that He is living, that He has defeated death, and that He is the only hope outside of everything this world has to offer to come into the presence of the one true living God who created you and who is patiently waiting for you to step into a life of repentance where you turn to Him and turn away from the priorities of yourself. Thank you so much for tuning into this Bible Speed Art today. I hope it has encouraged you. I hope it has uplifted you as it has me. Gabe, thank you for being a part of this. Again, I love you, dude. You're awesome. Continue to seek where the Lord has you in life and walk in His ways always. You know what? If you're listening to this and you're in need of prayer, please reach out to us on our website at perhapstoday.net and let us know how we can better serve you through prayer. Or maybe you know someone who can benefit from this lesson today. Please share it with them on your social media pages, through email, or just go tell them in person. These videos were meant to be shared, and we will share it because we are the church. Thank you so much. God bless.